happy? Are you all ready for the class? Okay, good. Do you remember what are we learning now? What is the title of your first lesson? The Little Prince Visits the King. The Little Prince Visits the King. About whom are we learning? About a little prince. Shall we revise what we have learned it? A little prince found himself among the asteroids, among the planets in space. And he tries to get knowledge more about other planets, and so he starts his journey. At first, whom he met? He met a king. His ermine robe covers the entire planet, isn't it? And at once the king saw this little prince. The king welcomes him warmly. He calls this little prince as a subject. And then this little prince is thinking, I have never met him before. How is he welcoming me warmly? This is because the king have been living all alone in that planet for so many years, isn't it? Then, because of tiredness, what the little prince did? The little prince starts to yawn. Then the king said, this is not the right manners to behave in front of a king. This is not the correct etiquette. Then the little prince said, I can't help. It will come automatically to me. And then the king orders him to yawn again, but now the little prince refuses to do. The king said, if I order any general to turn himself into a seabird, he will change. If not, that is not his mistake, that is my mistake. Then the little prince finds himself, he wants to sit somewhere. And the little prince asks the king, shall I sit down? And the king orders, okay, you can take your seat. Then again, this little prince is asking so many questions to the king. What he asks then, over what are you ruling? The king replies, over everything, all the planets, all the stars, all are under the control of me. I'm the universal king. Then the king said, do the stars obey you? Then the king said, yes. All the stars will obey me because all my orders are reasonable. By now, the little prince remembers about his own planet. He left his planet, isn't it? And now he wants to see the sunset again. And this little prince is thinking, if I am in the place of this king, I will order the sun to set, not for 22 times, not for 44 times, not for 72 times, but for more than 200 times, I will ask the sun to set. Then this little prince wants to see the sunset. So he asked the king, shall I see the sunset? And the king said, yes, you can see. I will order the sun to set. He will surely obey me. But before that, you have to wait. This is what we have seen in the last class, isn't it? Do you remember all these things? Okay, shall we see what happened next? Now, the king is taking his almanac and is searching about to get the information about the sun. Because the little prince asks him, I want to see the sunset, isn't it? So this king take that almanac. What is an almanac? Almanac is a calendar in which we can get more information about the sun, moon and all the planets, stars there in space. So the king takes that almanac and is searching the information about the sun. And he said, today evening about 20 minutes to 8, we can see the sunset. The sun will surely obey me. 20 minutes to 8, which means by 7:40, we can see the sunset. The sun will surely obey me. Then again the little prince yawned. He wanted to see the sunset, but still
he feels very bored there. Because there is only one king, only one person to speak with. So this little boy, this little prince feels very bored and he decides to set on his way. He decides to go. He decides to continue his journey. Because he started his journey to see, to visit all the planets. The first planet he visits is the king's planet. He has to go for so many planets to visit, isn't it? So this little prince decides, okay, this is enough. And so I shall set out on my way again. I shall start my journey again. But the king did not allow him. The king said, do not go. Please don't go. Because just now I feel very proud of having a subject. Till today, till that time, that king was living all alone in that planet. And now he got a subject to rule over. And so this king said, please don't go. Please do not go. I will make you as a minister. Minister? Minister of what? The king said, minister of justice. I will make you as the minister of justice. But there is nobody there in that planet, isn't it? Only the king was living there. So whom the little prince will judge? The king said, I have not visited this planet completely. I don't have any chariot to visit the entire, to go around my planet. I have no room to keep my carriage, that is a chariot. He have to walk all alone. He have to walk all over his planet to visit. And so the king did not have a visit, did not make a visit for his entire planet. And so the king is asking the little prince, you can be here, please, you can be here and you can judge others. Sometimes somebody will be here. I did not visit my entire planet yet. So you please stay here. Then the little prince looked around everywhere. He did not find anybody. And this little prince said, dear king, there is nobody in your planet except you. How can I judge others? Then the king said, okay, then you can judge yourself. The king said so. Because judging oneself, if I am judging myself, that is a very, very difficult task for me. If somebody is asking me to judge others, I will judge them quickly. I will judge them with more interest, isn't it? If I am asking you to judge yourself, will you judge it correctly, judge yourself correctly? If I ask you to judge your friend, or if I ask you to judge your brother or sister, at once you will say, he is a bad boy, he is a bad girl, isn't it? He will do this, he will do that, she will do this, she will do that. Then what about yourself? What about you? Did you ever think of that? We never try to judge ourselves, isn't it? We will blame on others. We will say so many mistakes about others. But we never consider, we never realize our own mistakes. We will say, he is bad, she is bad. But what about us? Do we say, I am bad? I am a bad girl, I am a bad boy. Do we say? No, we will say every wrong things about others, but we will not say anything wrong about us, about ourselves, isn't it? I am a good girl, I am a good boy. This is what our judgment about others. So the king here is saying, you can judge yourself. That is the most difficult task, to judge ourselves. If we judge ourselves correctly, then we will get a true wisdom. Okay, But we cannot judge ourselves correctly. If we judge ourselves correctly in the correct manner, we will get true wisdom and knowledge. Then the little prince said, yes, I can judge myself, but for that, for judging myself, is there any compulsion to stay in your planet? I can judge myself wherever I can. There is no compulsion for me to stay in your planet to judge myself. So, I am leaving. Again, the king is trying to stop him. Then the king said, I have an old rat in my planet. So, please judge that little old rat. What the king is saying? I have an old rat. Have you all seen rat? Yes. I have an old rat in my planet. So, you please judge that old rat. And so, please stay here in my planet. And the king is again saying, you have to judge that old rat and you have to punish him for his actions. You have to condemn him. Condemn means punishment. So you have to condemn him to death. And also you have to condemn him to death. You have to punish him to death. But also you have to pardon him. What does it mean by pardoning? Forgiving. You have to forgive him. And also you have to punish him. You have to do two works. One, you have to punish him. And also you have to forgive him in each occasions. Please treat him carefully. The king is asking the little prince, you have to judge an old rat. An old rat is here in my planet. You can judge that old rat. And again he is saying, you have to punish the old rat to death and also forgives him. And please treat him carefully because he is the only one we have to judge in this planet. Other than that old rat, there is nobody for us to judge here. Then the little prince said, I will not judge others. I will not punish others. I will not condemn anyone to death. I am going on my way. Please leave me. I am not ready to judge that old rat. I am not ready to forgive that. I am not ready to condemn that old rat. So please leave me. I am going on my way. The king said, no, please don't go. Then the little prince is getting ready. He is packing everything to move from that planet. He don't want that king to feel sad. So he is getting ready. He is preparing everything. He is packing everything in his bag and is ready to leave that planet. And the king, he is thinking within himself that if the king orders me something which is logical, something which is reasonable, I could have stayed here. But he did not say anything logical, anything reasonable. And so I am leaving. The king also did not reply to him anything. The king just keep silence. And then he is saying, I will make you as my ambassador. So please stay here. But the little prince starts his journey and moves away from that planet. And the little prince is thinking within himself that old people, grown-ups, old people, they are very strange. They are very different. They are unfamiliar. We cannot judge their characters. So by saying this, this little prince is going and he starts his journey. Thus our lesson comes to an end. Have you all understood, students?
The little prince found himself in the neighborhood of the asteroids 325, 326, 327, 328, 329, and 330. He began therefore, by visiting them, in order to add to his knowledge. The first of them was inhabited by a king, clad in royal purple and ermine. He was seated upon a throne which was at the same time both simple and majestic.
"Ah, here is the subject,"
exclaimed the king when he saw the little prince coming. And the little prince asked himself,
"How could he recognize me when he had never seen me before?"
He did not know how the world is simplified for kings. To them, all men are subjects.
"Approach, so that I may see you better,"
said the king, who felt consumingly proud of being at last a king over somebody. The little prince looked everywhere to find a place to sit down. But the entire planet was crammed and obstructed by the king's magnificent ermine robe. So he remained standing upright. And since he was tired, he yawned.
"It is contrary to etiquette to yawn in the presence of a king,"
the monarch said to him.
"I forbid you to do so." "I can't help it. I can't stop myself,"
replied the little prince, thoroughly embarrassed.
"I have come on a long journey, and I have had no sleep." "Ah, then,"
the king said,
"I order you to yawn. It is years since I have seen anyone yawning. Yawns to me are objects of curiosity. Come now, yawn again. It is an order."
That frightens me. I cannot any more,"
murmured the little prince, now completely abashed. Replied the king.
"Then I order you sometimes to yawn and sometimes to
He sputtered a little and seemed vexed, for what the king insisted upon was that his authority should be respected. He tolerated no disobedience. He was an absolute monarch. But because he was a very good man, he made his orders reasonable.
"If I ordered a general,"
he would say, by way of example,
"if I ordered a general to change himself into a seabird, and if the general did not obey me, that would not be the fault of the general. It would be my fault."
"May I sit down?"
came now a timid inquiry from the little prince.
"I order you to do so,"
the king answered him, and majestically gathered in a fold of his ermine mantle. But the little prince was wondering. The planet was tiny. Over what could this king really rule?
"Sire,"
he said to him,
"I beg that you will excuse my asking you a question."
"I order you to ask me a question,"
the king hastened to assure him.
"Sire, over what do you rule?"
"Over everything,"
said the king with magnificent simplicity.
"Over everything?"
The king made a gesture which took in his planet, the other planets, and all the stars.
"Over all that?"
asked the little prince.
"Over all that,"
the king answered, for his rule was not only absolute, it was also universal.
"And the stars obey you?"
"Certainly they do,"
the king said.
"They obey instantly. I do not permit insubordination."
Such power was a thing for the little prince to marvel at. If he had been master of such complete authority, he would have been able to watch the sunset, not 44 times in one day, but 72, or even 100, or even 200 times, without ever having to move his chair. And because he felt a bit sad as he remembered his little planet which he had forsaken, he plucked up his courage to ask the king a favor.
"I should like to see a sunset. Do me that kindness. Order the sun to set."
"If I ordered a general to fly from one flower to another like a butterfly, or to change himself into a seabird, and if the general did not carry out the order that he had received, which one of us would be in the wrong?"
the king demanded.
"The general or myself?"
"You,"
said the little prince firmly.
Exactly. One must require from each one the duty which each one can perform.
The king went on.
Accepted authority rests first of all on reason. I have the right to require obedience because my orders are reasonable.
Then my sunset?
The little prince reminded him, for he never forgot a question once he had asked it.
You shall have your sunset. I shall command it. But according to my science of government, I shall wait.
Students, it's time to read the text. May I sit down? Came now a timid inquiry from the little prince. I order you to do so, the king answered him, and majestically gathered in a fold of his ermine mantle. But the little prince was wondering. The planet was tiny. Over what could this king really rule? Sir, he said to him, I beg that you will excuse my asking you a question. I order you to ask me a question. The king hastened to assure him. Sir, over what do you rule? Over everything, said the king with magnificent simplicity. Over everything? The king made a gesture which took in his planet, the other planets and all the stars. Over all that? Asked the little prince. Over all that, the king answered. For his rule was not only absolute, it was also universal. And the stars obey you? Certainly they do, the king said. They obey instantly. I do not permit insubordination. Such power was a thing for the little prince to marvel at. If he had been master of such complete authority, he would have been able to watch the sunset not 44 times in one day, but 72 or even 100 or even 200 times without ever having to move his chair. And because he felt a bit sad as he remembered his little planet which he had forsaken, he plucked up his courage to ask the king a favor. I should like to see a sunset. Do me that kindness. Order the sun to set. If I ordered a general to fly from one flower to another like a butterfly, or to change himself into a seabird, and if the general did not carry out the order that I had received, which one of us would be in the wrong? The king demanded. The general or myself? You, said the little prince firmly. Exactly. One must require from each one the duty which each one can perform, the king went on. Accepted authority rests first of all on reason. I have the right to require obedience because my orders are reasonable. Then my sunset? The little prince reminded him, for he never forgot a question once he had asked it. You shall have your sunset. I shall command it. But according to my science of government, I shall wait until conditions are favorable. When will that be? Inquired the little prince. Replied the king, and before saying anything else, he consulted a bulky almanac. That will be this evening, about 8:20, and you will see how well I am obeyed. The little prince yawned. He was regretting his lost sunset, and then, too, he was already beginning to be a little bored. "I have nothing more to do here," he said to the king, "so I shall set out on my way again." "Do not go," said the king, who was very proud of having a subject. "Do not go, I'll make you a minister."
"Minister of what?"
"Minister of justice."
"But there's nobody here to judge."
"We do not know that," the king said to him. "I have not yet made a complete tour of my kingdom. I am very old. There's no room here for a carriage, and it tires me to walk."
"Oh, but I have looked already," said the little prince, turning around to give one more glance to the other side of the planet. "On that side, as on this, there is nobody at all."
"Then you shall judge yourself," the king answered. "That is the most difficult thing of all."
"It is much more difficult to judge oneself than to judge others. If you succeed in judging yourself rightly, then you are indeed a man of true wisdom."
"Yes," said the little prince, "but I can judge myself anywhere. I do not need to live on this planet."
Said the king. "I have good reason to believe that somewhere on my planet there is an old rat. I hear him at night. You can judge this old rat. From time to time, you will condemn him to death. Thus, his life will depend on your justice. But you will pardon him on each occasion, for he must be treated thriftily. He is the only one we have."
"I," replied the little prince, "do not like to condemn anyone to death. And now I think I'll go on my way."
"No," said the king. But the little prince, having now completed his preparations for departure, had no wish to grieve the old monarch. "If your majesty wishes to be promptly obeyed," he said, "he should be able to give me a reasonable order. He should be able, for example, to order me to be gone by the end of 1 minute. It seems to me that conditions are favorable." As the king made no answer, the little prince hesitated a moment. Then, with a sigh, he took his leave.
"I made you my ambassador," the king called out hastily. He had a magnificent air of authority. "The grown-ups are very strange," the little prince said to himself as he continued on his journey. It's time to learn the new vocabularies. Take page number 13. Hastened. Here, said something without delay. The king replied to the little prince without any delay. That is hastened. Gesture. A movement that you make with your hands, your head, or your face to show a particular meaning. Gesture. A movement that you make with your hands, your head, or your face to show a particular meaning. Insubordination. The refusal to obey orders or show respect for somebody who has a higher rank. Insubordination. The refusal to obey orders to show respect for somebody who has a higher rank. Marvel at. Be very surprised or impressed by something. Marvel at. Be very surprised or impressed by something. Almanac, a calendar that gives information about the sun, moon and tides for every day of the year. Almanac, a calendar that gives information about the sun, moon and tides for every day of the year. Condemn. Say what someone's punishment will be. Condemn. Say what someone's punishment will be. Thriftly. Carefully. Thriftly. Carefully. Grieve. To make someone feel sad. Grieve. To make someone feel sad.